Hi everyone, my name is Chantel and welcome back to my channel. A couple of weeks ago I asked you if you were interested in a Q&A session and here we are. Today I will answer 35 questions that have been asked by you. Whilst I do that, there will be footage playing of me creating two sketchbooks with polymer clay covers, which I will give away when my channel reaches 20,000 subscribers. But without further ado, let's get into the questions. Question 1. When did you start crafting? I can't really recall when I started crafting, but I suppose everyone starts when they are very young. My grandmother taught me to sew, and my mom taught me how to crochet. I think I've always been creative, but only in the last 5 years I really developed myself as an artist. Question 2. When or how did you start making miniatures? It all started with the Harry Potter miniature room where I created a cabinet. I was first thinking of just making the cabinet and then thought, why not make a whole room? So that was my first ever miniature diorama which I created. I think it was in May last year in 2019. So that was the very first one and I will link it in the description box below and in the icon section just in case you haven't seen it yet. Question 3. Is this your profession or just a hobby? If it's a hobby, is it an expensive one to take up? It is definitely a hobby, but one I take very seriously. I absolutely love to inspire people with my creations. Getting into the YouTube realm, it is slowly but surely becoming a hobby made into a profession. It is as expensive as you want it to be. If you've been around my channel for a while, you know that cardboard, tissue paper, egg cartons and PVA glue will go a long way. I do have a second channel, which I will link in the iCard, where I create journals and do watercolor paintings as well. Question 4. Did you study art? Do you have an art degree? No, I did not study art and I do not have an art degree. Question 5. When do you craft usually, day or night? I usually craft during the evening. During the day, I am a full-time mum. Question 6. Where do all your ideas come from? What inspires you to create? As you might know, I am a big fan of Tim Burton. Everything he creates, I absolutely love. Movies like The Shape of Water, Pan's Labyrinth, The Cure for Wellness, The Imaginarium of Dr. Parnassus, they inspire me. They have a certain vibe and atmosphere that I really enjoy. If you know of any more of these kind of movies, please let me know in the comments down below. And of course, I am a big fan of the Harry Potter franchise. Question 7. What sparked your love for small things? All little things are cute, and when you look at a diorama or miniature, there is just something about them that makes you want to shrink down to miniature size and disappear into that little world that is created. Question 8. What would be your dream project? This is a very difficult question. My absolute dream project would be to work with Tim Burton on one of his projects. We are talking big, big dreams here, all right. This is probably never going to happen. Question 9. What is your favorite project you've done so far? My favorite project is probably my second ever diorama, which is the Edgar Allan Poe room. Question 10. What is the craziest idea you had but have yet to make? Making the Hogwarts castle out of matchsticks. Question 11. Do you have unfinished or abandoned projects? No, I don't. Question 12. Does it ever happen that you start a project and then get inspired to work on another at the same time? And how do you juggle that? Yes, every minute of every day. But I simply can't take on another project and I force myself to finish one first before I start the next one. And yes, this can be very, very difficult. Question 13. Would you consider making some Lord of the Rings items like Treebeard, Saruman's Tower or a Hobbit house like Bag End? Yes, I'm planning on doing something like that in November 2021. Question 14. How about something from Labyrinth, the movie starring David Bowie? I will add it to the list of possible future projects. Question 15. Have you ever thought about making an exhibition room for your creations? Yes, if I had the room for it, absolutely. But this is all future plans. Hagrid's hut might end up on display somewhere locally next year. Question 16. Why did you decide to create a YouTube channel? Simply to share my creations with you and spark creativity. Question 17. Where does the name of your channel come from? My husband and I share a love for ravens and Edgar Allan Poe, which is simply too hard to explain in words. So take the gothic element that Poe brings for darkest and the love for ravens, and you have darkest raven designs. Question 18. What was your goal when you first started your YouTube channel? My aim with this channel is to make people happy and inspire others with my creations. Question 19. Any advice for smaller YouTubers? Do what you love and don't give up. Collaborate as much as possible with channels similar to yours and with content that you like. Question 20. What editing program do you use and how long does it take to edit a video? I use Adobe Premiere Pro. Editing depends on how long the project has taken me. For instance, Hagrid's Hut was 2 days of editing per video, as in a smart art box video would be one night. Question 21. Where do you see your channel in 5 years? I will hopefully be continuing to make people happy and inspire others. Question 22. Do you have any dream collaborations? Absolutely. Think about Nerdy Crafter, Jezza, Delightful, Ace of Clay. If you want any of these collaborations to happen, feel free to leave a comment on their last videos. Question 23. What is the best advice or tips that you yourself have got in your creative making process? Create for yourself first. There are always people out there that will like your style. Keep practicing. It doesn't always make perfect, but it will make you more confident in what you're doing. Question 24. Do you have a specific way to prepare for a project like sketching or mock-ups? It depends on the project. Sometimes I don't prepare at all and I just go in full force. But for something like the Harry Potter matchboxes, I do quite a bit of research. Question 25. How do you make sure you have the right skill for building the miniatures? This is very much trial and error. Sometimes I use a skill conversion tool that I will link in the description box down below. Question 26. What amount of detail is made up by you and how do you decide what to include? Some of my content is inspired and some of it is original. The amount of detail is always decided by me. Question 27. Is there a way to not spend too much money when buying products? Go with the stuff you can afford and find ways to incorporate things that you have around the house. Quality is not linked to price tag. Question 28. What are your must-have, most-used tools and art supplies? Must-haves are tweezers, scissors, a craft knife, and a good glue like Gorilla Wood Glue and Fabri-Tac glue. I will leave a list of the materials I use down below in an Amazon link where you can also purchase them. Question 29. What is your favorite medium to use? Polymer clay and, in traditional art, watercolors. Question 30. Do you own any miniature making books? If so, which ones? I do own 2 books that I both bought for $3 each. And the first one is Making Miniatures in 1/12th Scale by Venus and Martin Dodge. And the second one is Making Dolls Houses in 1/12th Scale by Brian Nichols. I will leave, if I can find the links to these, a link in the description box below. And to be honest, I actually have not looked into these books yet to create my miniatures to date, because I simply haven't had time for it yet. Question 31. What kinds of brushes do you use and how do you clean and store them? I use cheap brushes that have plastic handles, which I buy at the supermarket for $5 for a 15 pack. I store them upright when dry. I clean them about once a week for the ones I've used, and they sit in a jar of water after use. Yes, it's bad, but this is just the way I roll. Question 32. All-time favorite book, movie, and song. My all-time favorite book right now is Nevermore by Jessica Townsend. It is very close to the Harry Potter realm, but set in the city of Nevermore, and it is darker, but also it is linked to Edgar Allan Poe, and that's one of the reasons I like it. Favorite movie of all time must be Corpse Bride by Tim Burton. And favorite song? There's too much music on this planet, so I am going to say for this one, anything by Muse. If I had to pick right now, it would be the acoustic version of Something Human. Question 33. What do you like about the Harry Potter world? The atmosphere, the art, and visuals created. So basically everything. Question 34. If you would have one Harry Potter original prop, what would you choose? That would probably be the Marauder's Map. And last but certainly not least, question 35. What have you always wanted to do but never had the courage to do? Become a forensic pathologist. And this is it for the Q&A session. I hope you enjoyed watching the creation of these two sketchbooks, as well as getting to know me a little bit better. If you have any questions for future Q&A sessions, please leave them in the comments down below. If you liked it, please give this video a thumbs up. It really helps my channel out. Make sure to check out my socials and consider supporting me on Patreon. And if you're new here, welcome! Please don't forget you can click the subscribe button to become part of the Raven family. Thanks so much for watching, stay safe, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye!